Hi guys, welcome to the session here. So in today's session, we will be talking about the detailed notification of your IBPS RRB GBO examination. So if you are preparing for this general banking officer's position, if you have a 2 years experience in the banking or financial field, you can absolutely apply for this particular examination. So if you are preparing for it, so let's quickly understand that what are the qualifications, what are the criteria that are required for this particular examination, right? So chalo, let's quickly start this session here. But before that, I hope everybody has already downloaded the app for Olivewood, and also you must have subscribed to the official channel of Olivewood. Nahi kiya hai, toh jaldi se kar lo. So what is this particular examination? Today we will be discussing the GBO, right? This is your officer scale 2, okay? So this is not scale 1, this is the scale 2. So generalists and specialists. So we are talking about the GBO here. So here you can see there will be a single online examination. There is no prelims plus mains and then interview. We will have only one single examination, online examination, and the shortlisted candidates will be then called for a common interview to be coordinated by the nodal regional rural banks with the help of NABARD and IBPS in consultation with the appropriate authority. So there will be a single examination followed by the interview process here. Okay, so let's understand what are the different criteria of eligibility for this particular examination. Nationality and citizenship is absolutely the same for this examination like you have in other banking examinations, like you must be a citizen of India or must be a subject of Nepal, a subject of Bhutan, or a Tibetan refugee who came over India before 1st January 62 with the intention of permanently settling in India, or a person of Indian origin who has migrated from Pakistan, Burma, Sri Lanka, East African countries of Kenya, Uganda, United Republic of Tanzania, Zambia, Malawi, Zaire, Ethiopia, Vietnam, with the intention of permanently settling in India, provided that a candidate belonging to categories above shall be a person in whose favor a certificate of eligibility has been issued by the government of India. So this is about your nationality and citizenship. Okay, so if you are a citizen of India, don't worry about it. And even if 2, 3, 4 or 5 you fulfill, absolutely you can apply for this. But there are other criteria also. What is the age criteria here? For general candidates, you can see we have 21 to 32 years. Okay, there are other relaxation for SC, ST, OBC, EWS, or let's say we have for divorced women, right? So there are a lot of this one. So do check it out, right? So for general candidates, you can see it is 21 to 32. In normal banking, like in RRB PO, you have 30. But here we have 32 because we are talking about the scale 2 manager post here. Okay. So candidates should not have been born earlier than 3rd of June 1992 and later than 31st of May 2003, both dates inclusive. So if you are between this particular range, you can absolutely apply in here. So if you are not born before 1992, 3rd June, and not after 31st of May 2003, you can apply in here. And these dates are also included, that is 3rd June 1992 is also included, and similarly 31st of May 2003 is also included in here. But let's say if you are born on 1st of August 2003, then you are not eligible here. Similarly, if you are on 2nd June 1992, you are still not eligible here. Okay, so it has to be between these two dates here. Similarly, what is the what is the educational qualification that you require here? So for general banking officer, the manager scale, scale 2 officers, you can see bachelor's degree in any discipline from a recognized university or its equivalent with a minimum of 50% marks in aggregate. So you should be graduate with minimum 50% from a recognized university, right? So there is a criteria of percentage also, which is 50%. Preference will be given to candidates having degree in banking, finance, marketing, agriculture, horticulture, forestry, animal husbandry, veterinary science, agricultural engineering, and so on. But it does not mean that if you have only these degrees, then only you can apply. It is given preference. Okay, preference will be given to these candidates, but it does not mean that, like, let's say you have done a BSc here, normal BSc, then you cannot apply, or let's say you have a BA degree, then you cannot apply. No, not necessary, right? Preference will be given, but you can absolutely apply in here. Also, you should have a 2 years. This is absolutely necessary. So, what is the experience required? 2 years as an officer in a bank or financial institution. So, if you have this particular experience, then only you can apply for the officer scale 2 examination, right? So, please remember the nationality was there. Then we have the age criteria from 21 to 32. Then we require a bachelor's degree with 50% aggregate, and then you have to have an experience of 2 years, minimum 2 years, as an officer in a bank or in a financial institution. Now, what is the application fees here? You can see for officers scale 1, 2 and 3, so scale 2 we are talking about, it's 850 for all other persons and 175 for SC, ST, PWBD candidates here. So for a general candidate, you have 850, right? So general EWS, you have rupees 850 only, right? And you can see that online payment has to be done from 7th June onwards to 27th June onwards, right? So the you can fill in the form from these dates only, right? So 7th June to 27th June only, this one is open here, right? So do not forget to fill in the form beforehand, right? Don't wait for the last date, right? Please uska wait mat karna ki last date mein bharenge, because it may be possible that the server gets heavy in the end. So please fill it beforehand, okay? Usko pehle se bhar lena. Now, what is the division of the questions that will be asked in here? Okay, so yahan par dekho, you can see we will have 5 sections in here. We will have reasoning. There is single examination, single level examination for the GBO, right? So we will have reasoning, 40 questions, 50 marks. Computer knowledge, 40 questions, 20 marks. Financial awareness, 40 questions, 40 marks. Similarly, you will have either English language or Hindi language for 40 questions, 40 marks. And you will have quantitative aptitude on data interpretation for 40 questions, 50 marks. So you can see the highest weightage will be for reasoning and quant in here. 100 questions, 100 marks will be there out of 200. That is 50% weightage is to reasoning and quant itself. And you can see that there is a composite time of 2 hours, but they have given a dollar sign. Now, what does this dollar means? It means that there can be a composite time, but they can change it to this one, section wise timing as well. So that will be told to you in the information handout that they will provide. So when the information handout is provided, they will let you know whether it is going to be a composite timing or whether they will have this division here, right? That is separate sections timing will be there. Okay, so do not worry about that. That will be later communicated to you. So just prepare as per the this notification that we have a composite timing of 2 hours, but be prepared to have a sectional timing as well, right? So keep your timings. Let's say if we have 20 minutes, right? So 20 into 5 is 100. So let's say we have something around 20, 22 minutes for each of the sections, right? So you have to do it as per that only, okay? Chalo, let's understand what is going to be the penalty for wrong answers. Like in other banking examinations, here also you will have 1/4 or 0.25 as the 0.25 of the marks assigned. So let's say if we have 1 marks for that question, 0.25 will be deducted from there, right? 1/4 of the marks assigned. So for positive, if you have 1, that means for negative, you will have a minus 0.25. If the question is of 2 marks, then it will be 2 ka 1 by 4, that is 0.5. Right, so 1/4 of the marks assigned will be deducted in here. If you are not answering a particular question, then there is no negative marking. It will be taken as a 0. Right, so for no answer, there is no negative marking in here. No penalty for no answer. Okay. Now, what is the cutoff score here? You can see for scale 2 officers, what is going to be the cutoff score? Each candidate will be required to obtain a minimum score in each of the sections, right? Each test of online single examination to be considered to be shortlisted for the interview. So you should have a minimum score, right? There will be a sectional score here for each of the sections to be shortlisted for the interview, and there will be an overall score also, okay? Depending on the number of vacancies available, adequate number of candidates in each category not exceeding 3 times of the declared vacancies shall be called for the interview. So let's say if there are 30 vacancies in there, so not more than 90 persons will be called in for the interview, right? So not exceeding 3 times of the declared vacancy shall be called for the interview, subjected to availability. Prior to the completion of interview process, code obtained by the online main examination will not be shared before the shortlisting here, right? So before interview, you will not be told about your marks here, right? You will just know whether you are qualified or whether you are not qualified, whether you have to appear for the interview or not, okay? You will not be shared your marks here, okay? Then what are the scores obtained? How do we find the scores obtained in the online examination? So you can see for the post of officer scale 2 and scale 3, marks obtained in the single level online examination will be considered for shortlisting for interview and final merit listing. So there will be one paper where you score, whatever you score, that will be considered for the final shortlisting for the interview and also for the final merit list. Okay. Similarly, examination centers, you have to be very careful while filling in the examination centers, because the examinations happen at that particular examination center only, right? Generally, if you fill in Lucknow, it's most probably you will get Lucknow, but they have mentioned that it may be possible that they may change, okay, depending on the availability of the center. It is given here that a candidate may be allocated a center exam, his exam outside his state or union territory for which he or she is applying, right? So that is on the bank, on the availability they will be assigning. So it's on them, right? So unke hisab se hoga. If there is no availability, they may assign an outside center also, and you may have to travel, right? That's absolutely possible here. Now, what are the this one here applicable only for the post of this one? So how do we have the interviews here? What are the things that they have said for interviews? Candidates who have been shortlisted for the mains examination for the post of officer scale 1 in single level or scale 2 or 3 under this will be subsequently called for an interview to be coordinated by the nodal regional rural bank by the assistance of NABARD and IBPS in consultation with the appropriate authority. Now you can see here that how they are going to have the division of the marks. The total marks allocated for the interview are 100. Minimum qualifying marks in interview will not be less than 40%, 35% for SCST, OBC, PWBD candidates, right? So you have to have minimum 40% marks here, minimum qualifying marks. But that does not ensure that you will become a GPO in the this one. There will be a merit list also, right? So minimum 40%, it will not be less than 40%. It has to be something greater than that. The relative weightage of online examination and interview will be 80:20 for officer status. So officer scale 2, it will be 80:20. That is, higher weightage will be given to the written. So here you have to be very, very well prepared for the written examination, because 80% weightage is for the online written examination and 20% is for the interview. Okay. Now, what is the procedure for applying online? You just have to visit www.ibps.in. Then you can see here that click here to apply online for CRB, RRB's officers. Click here to apply online for office assistants or that for the GPO, right? So be very careful. So you have to select this because you are applying for scale 2. Okay, so click here to apply online for CRP, RRB's officers, scale 1, 2 and 3. And there you will have to select scale 2, that is your GPO. Okay, if you are new registration, if you are doing it for the first time, if you have not done it before, you will be doing your click here for new registration. If you have, like, let's say half of the form you have submitted and you already have a registration number, then you will be using the same, right? It is not that yes, last year's registration number will be useful in here. So if you are doing it for the first time this year, then you will have to do it for new registration, right? And you will have to require, you will be required to have all these. That is, you will be required to upload photographs, signature, left hand thumb impression, a handwritten declaration. Be careful about the handwritten declaration, guys. Whatever is mentioned there, please write that only. And now, usi ko likhna. Certificates mentioned in this one, so do check it out. Candidates will also be required to capture and upload their photograph through webcam or mobile phone during the registration process, right? So do be careful about all these things here, okay? Now, what are the this one? That is, how many vacancies are there for general banking officers? We all know about the scale 1. We all have discussed about multipurpose here. But what about GBO? How many vacancies do we have? Like here, you can see Assam Grameen Vikas Bank has how many? In total, you can see there are 10 vacancies in here, right? It has. Similarly, Bongio Grameen Vikas Bank, right? So you can see a lot of vacancies. 59 vacancies are here in Bongio Grameen Vikas Bank. Okay. Then this Baroda Gujarat Grameen Bank has not told about it. Similarly, here also Baroda Rajasthan Kshetriya Grameen Bank, they have also not reported it here as of yet. They can report, right? So they have still not reported. Like these have already said that there are no vacancies, right? Andhra Pradesh Grameen Bank 0000. So they are not going to report anything here. But these can report. Wherever you have an NR, they will still have reporting here. Right? So you can see Baroda UP Bank, they have also not reported, so there may be a possibility. Chhattisgarh Rajya Grameen Bank, we have 38 vacancies here. Then Ilaki Dehati Bank, you can see one vacancy here. Similarly, this Himachal Pradesh also has 7 vacancies. JNK Grameen Bank not reported. Then we have Jharkhand Rajya Grameen Bank, 18 vacancies in here, right? Similarly, you can see Madhyanchal Grameen Bank, 28 vacancies. Then Meghalaya Rural Bank, you can see 3 vacancies. This Prathama UP Grameen Bank, 64 vacancies, the highest till now, isn't it? Isse pehle 59 tha yahan par, then 38. But here we have 64. So Prathama Bank has a lot of vacancies for GBO. Punjab Grameen Bank, 85 vacancies, a huge number of vacancies here. Rajasthan Marudhar Grameen Bank, 45 vacancies. Saptagiri Grameen Bank, NR, that is not reported. Sarva Haryana Grameen Bank, 38. Saurashtra Grameen Bank, you can see 23. Telangana Grameen Bank is 40. Then we have Utkal Grameen Bank as 13. Uttar Bihar Grameen Bank not reported. Uttarakhand Grameen Bank 11. Then we have Uttarbang Kshetriya Grameen Bank as 13. Right? So you can see these are the vacancies in the Grameen Banks for your GBO examination. So if you are preparing, do well prepare, because there is a lot of vacancies in here, right? Vacancies to hai. Prepare well. There is only one single examination followed by an interview here, right? So if you are preparing for this upcoming examination, we have the perfect course for you, where you can prepare well with us, right? So if you have any doubts that how should we prepare, what will be the level of the questions, from where to prepare, what kind of questions can come in the examination, so do check out this crash course, that is the IBPS RRB GBO 2024 60 days crash course. Now it is available in bilingual as well as in Hindi, right? Bilingual as well as in English. So medium of communication is not going to be a problem anymore. राइट तो अगर आपको इंग्लिश में पढ़ना है इंग्लिश में पढ़ सकते हैं अगर बाइलिंगुअल चाहिए तो बाइलिंगुअल में भी मिल जाएगा है ना सो एनरोल नाउ यू कैन यूज द कूपन कोड एनी फैकल्टी कूपन कोड यू कैन यूज माय कूपन कोड आल्सो टू अवेल द मैक्सिमम डिस्काउंट्स इन हियर सो आई होप यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग राइट अभी आपको समझ में आ ही गया होगा कि किस तरह से प्रिपरेशन करनी है एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट थिंग्स दैट यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड फॉर फिलिंग दिस फॉर्म राइट We will be having more informative videos about the, let's say, what is the syllabus, what was the cutoff, right? Everything we will be discussing video-wise. So, bahut saare hum videos upload karte rahenge. So, if you are preparing for your GBO examination, do check out these videos here. Okay? So, chalo, thank you so much, guys. I'll see you with another session. So, please take care, stay safe, have a great day. I'll see you soon. Thank you.